So you just bought Combined Arms and you're getting into DCS and you want to know how to drive a tank. Well, I'm going to show you how to do that. First off, go ahead and hit your mission editor. Whether you've created a mission or not, this is really simple to do. And then go and create a new mission. From here, you can select whatever map you want and go ahead and press OK. This, of course, will load up the map. And once it is loaded up, we'll go ahead and change it from the bottom here, from Alt to Satellite. It's just a little easier to view the map, in my opinion. And then we will find a nice field, like so. And this will be a good place to place our tanks. So we'll go over on the left-hand side, and we'll find the ground units. And we'll go ahead and drop a ground unit in the middle of this field. You can see the radar signature, so anything within that radar signature will be fired upon immediately once we do press fly mission. From here, we'll go over to the other side. You can see we have our categories, armor. Up at the top is the country, so we're the USA right now, so we're blue. So it's going to be red versus blue. And down from there, type. And anything that we select that says player can drive and we can check it off is a vehicle that we are able to drive. So we'll find the Abrahams tank right here, MBT, main battle tank, and then M1A2 Abrahams, and we'll select that. And it should be facing due north when we do start the game, as it is. And you can see which way it's facing by this little roundabout here, and you can actually change it. So south would be all the way down, and of course up would be north. From here, we can go ahead and leave the tank right there. And let's go ahead and place a couple dummies for it to shoot at. So we'll go and select the static objects, add or modify static objects right here, and we'll drop a static object right in the line of sight. And first off, we'll change it to red, so Russia first off, and then go and do ground vehicles, and we'll go and find the main battle tanks, MBT, and we'll drop one of these. And there we go, so a tank. And we can even face it towards us, even though it is a static object, so it won't shoot at you when we start the game. And we'll copy that, so Control and C, and then Control and V, and we'll paste a couple of them there for target practice. Now, that's the blue side, so this is the blue tank right here. So to put another, say if you're going to play against your friend, for that, we'll need to add an enemy tank, so we'll go ahead and select ground units there, and we'll put an enemy tank a little bit of ways away so we're not firing at each other immediately. And from there we will do drop down to Russia, Russia, make it red, of course, and then we'll go and select an MBT, we'll select an older tank, a T-35, and we'll have it way up here, and so it's away from the battle, and yes, it should stay up there. Okay, so, and we did that so that we can show how to do the multiplayer. So, this will be helpful if you're going to play with your friends. So, from here, we want to do Battlefield Commanders. And then we're going to add a Game Master to each side. You can also add, if you don't want Game Masters, you can add everything else. But the Game Master can do everything. So, you can jump to each side if you want. You know, if you're trying to assist your friend, it's great for tutorials and stuff like that. Okay, so now that we've got that set up, we can go ahead and enter the game by pressing the play mission, that little green arrow, and then of course going yes and save, and we'll save this as test mission, and I already had a test mission, whatever, and we'll go ahead and select start. From here it should bring up which side you want to be on, so we'll choose the blue side. And then, like I said, select Game Master, and then press OK, and then press Fly. And then once you're on the mission screen, you can go ahead and select the tank, like so. And you can actually set a path, at add target, and do all that. But we want to get inside the tank, so we're going to go up to the top here and press the little tank icon, and that'll put us inside the tank, like so. You can see, we're inside the tank. Very cool. And so this is the main turret. If we want to switch, we press Q, so that'll switch us back to the machine gun on top, like so, and we can switch back and forth. From we can look outside tank by pressing F7, so that shows us the outside view of it. If you want to get rid of the tag actually too that says new call sign and all that, you can press Shift F10, Shift F10, and Shift F10. That'll even get rid of the little dot, and then there's nothing on your tank, which looks way better. And to drive the tank, we want to press W and then just press the X, tap the X button to put it in gear. And then A and D, while holding down W, will make a turn. And then S is the brakes. So that's how you stop. It does have flares too, so if you go outside, let's see, we'll zoom back a ways. If you press Alt and 1 and 2 and 3, so Alt 1, 2, 3, it's all different colors. It'll shoot off a bunch of flares. Yeah, that's awesome. Very cool. We jump back inside the tank by pressing F1. We can press N, and that'll turn on our night vision. And that looks pretty cool. Would be helpful if it was night. To fire it, which I just did by mistake, is this space button. And or you can press your left mouse button, like so. If you have it paired to a flight stick, it actually is the trigger button too. And so let's go jump back outside the tank, and we'll go drive up and find one of those dummy tanks that we placed. Where did we put them all? Well, I guess we can jump back to the map. Oh yeah, they're right in front of us somewhere. We just have to drive up this hill. Alright, and there's our dummy tanks right there. Let's stop here and we'll go back into the tank by pressing F1, and then we'll just target one right here, and then we'll press our space button and fire. And maybe we missed. We need to be up just a little bit more. That was cool how it ricocheted over it though. That was awesome. Fire again here, and there we go. And of course, once the target is annihilated, it does say target ceasefire. It'll still show up if you see it, but if you look on the map, it should be on. Yeah, so now there's only three of them, which is kind of cool. And then we'll go back in, press F7. You can see from outside of it, it's on fire. Looks really cool. All right, so jump back into the tank, and then I'll show you the machine gun. Let's find another tank. Oh, they really do blend in well, huh? Hard to see. There we go. Press Q to go to the machine gun. And then, of course, the fire is space bar again. Or you can hold down your left mouse button. And you can go outside of it, too, and watch it firing. It's reloading. Cool. Let's go back in Q, and let's just blow this sucker up. I'll go back out and show it. Boom. There she was. She went on fire. And so that's how you use the Abraham tank, basically. And if you want to switch to the other side, too, you would just go ahead and press F10 like that on the map. And then you find the other tank, which is way up here. And you can actually control that too. See, you can set a pass. You control the whole battlefield in this mode if you're the game master, which is kind of cool because you can do some really cool things. So same thing, if you wanted to control this tank, you would just go ahead and jump into it like that. And bam, you're in control. And the same thing, F7 and drive it. And yeah, so that's the whole entire ground game. That's how to do it if you're trying to figure it out. And it took me a while, and some of the videos were weird about it. So I hope this helps people out. And if you do have any questions, of course, leave them in the comments, and I'll try to help you out. And peace out. Ixul's Extreme!